having trouble finding the feeling good place with the end of a relationship. It ended in October, and I moved out not because I didn't love him, but because it was in an unhealthy place, and I thought some time and space would be good to sort things out. Then we had a big meeting in the park, and he tells me a month later that he has met the love of his life 3 weeks just after we separated, and married her 2 months later. And I
felt that space.
That space. big space. On cleaning up my energy, got to the angry spot that felt so good, got my life force back, got to be on the place of, oh, I should have done this, I should have done that. He called my mom in February, and that kind of threw me off. And then a month ago, I actually ran into him. And I
with
had
your car?
Actually, he pulled up behind me in his car, and I had a meltdown. And I was just, why is this impacting me so much? And I love him. And even a few days ago, he called my mom again. And this all, like, just that connection. So here's my question is that it doesn't feel good, just like never again anything. Because I miss him, I love him, like just that he's never in my life anymore. Yet if I see him and I'm just going to fall apart, and I so want to clean up my energy from this. I mean, I feel like I'm in a holding or stuck pattern. So I'm asking for some broader perspective here.
The thing that is very interesting about situations like this is that there's often the sensation that before I can move on, in other words, you were talking about wanting to move on. And so then you talked about wanting some space. And there is this feeling that now, because of what action he has taken, there is now some permanence to our current situation that precludes me from making any other decisions. It's the thing that is most interesting about co-creating. When you are interacting just you relative to things, sometimes you feel less hindering because you say, well, I can just clean up my vibration and then the universe will cooperate and bring to me the things that I want. But when you are talking about the thing being a relationship, then it feels more like co-creating when everything is co-creating. But it feels like now, even if you are to get clear about what you want, that now another person has made other decisions that keep you from now being able to get what you want. And we want you to understand that even though we know how strongly it must feel that way, it is never that way. Because all you ever had to, or ever still now have to, tend to, is the gap between where you are and where you want to be. Now, we do not believe that when you decided to move out, when you decided to cause that what you thought would be a temporary separation that is looking like a more than temporary situation, we do not believe at that point you knew what you wanted. You really knew what you did not want. Mm-hmm. And we started to say to you before the story got longer that it's not so much that you wanted to run away from that. It's not that you want to leave behind a relationship that isn't working. It is that you're wanting to walk toward one that is working. But prior to all of this, in fact, even now, we can feel that you have not started moving toward anything that you want, that it is still, and especially when you first left, it was what I'm trying to get away from. So it isn't unusual for things to begin going screwy when you know really clearly what you don't want, and you haven't yet let yourself know what you do want, and you haven't taken the time to find the feeling place of what you do want so that you can begin moving toward it. Now, having said all of that, it doesn't matter what has happened. It doesn't matter how much time has gone by. Still, your work is the same. Your work would be exactly the same if you said to us, I left and this other person is still percolating and waiting, and I'm just trying to decide whether I want to go back. It would not be different than if you say to us, as you just did, doesn't seem to be waiting, seems to have made another decision. It still makes no difference. Your work is exactly the same in any case. And what that is to reflect back on the relationship. Clearly, it wasn't the way you wanted it to be, or you wouldn't have taken such strong action. And it is always nicer if you can clean up your vibration before you begin moving. But there is never a reason to have regret, because you can always clean up your vibration. And further, we want to stay in a very strong way that if you now clean up your vibration, and if what you ultimately want is a renewal of that relationship, it will not matter in the short or the long run what he did in the interim any more than it matters what you did in the interim. Is that clear? In other words, it does not matter what decisions have been made. Once you clean up your once you first identify what it truly is you want, and you have not done that yet. Once you truly understand what it is that you want, and if what you want is a renewal of that relationship, and if you do bring yourself into vibrational alignment with that, it will not matter to you, after it all is said and done and settled, that he had an excursion in the meantime. It will not matter. Now, we don't know that that's the conclusion that you will come to. We think that the way you feel is exacerbated a little bit because you just went out and slammed the door and then he locked it. And you liked it better when you had control of the door slamming. And so there is a little bit of feeling of, I would have done something differently if I'd known what his response was going to be. But that's the interesting thing about all of this. We cannot say to you that what you did or his response to what you did is in any way threatening the happy life that you have conjured out of all of this. Now, before you went into greater detail with your story, we wanted to say to you that when you have such a strong sensation that you really want to move away like you did, often that powerful impulse is a very good reading on what would be the best plan of action for you. In other words, there is so much more that is before you than is behind you. There is so much wonderful potential for joyous life experience. And frankly, it will be easier for you to achieve alignment with the desires that your life has caused you to fashion if you start new than if you go back and try to clean up old. And ultimately, what you want is just to be joyous in a relationship, and you were not joyous in that relationship. So don't let the fact that you weren't really sure you wanted to go and you weren't the one that got to say really goodbye and somebody else did, don't let that cause confusion about where you were ultimately headed. It felt good to you to get moving on. And if we were standing in your physical shoes, we would not stop now and second guess ourselves about that decision.
Can you help me? I have tried the focus wheels, all those kind of things, and I can't, you're right, make that leap of feeling good about even another relationship.
Well, then
it's, or not feeling good, but just, I guess, will I ever be attracted to somebody? Will like I was with him? Or I just try him, and then I write at the top, try again. I can't seem to even find the starting place.
Well, if we were standing in your physical shoes, we would try to mentally put ourselves in the position that we were in the day that we decided to move out. And in other words, try to recapture that feeling, that decision, and then say to yourself, that was a good decision. In other words, that's a good starting place for you. That was a good decision. And we think that if you will start there, it will be easier for you to leap into good feeling things of other images. But you're not starting there. You're starting in an attitude of regret. In other words, can feel the difference between conjuring an image that makes you say, good for me, and then moving up the scale, or conjuring an image that makes you say, what was I thinking? And then try to move up the scale. In other words, it's a whole different place that you're starting. And a focus wheel, while it is designed to help you from even lower, not good feeling vibrations, it's much easier to start a focus wheel from a place of feeling good about a decision than from a place of feeling regret. Regret is one of the lowest, most resistant vibrations that exists, because not only is it a feeling of powerlessness, but it's a feeling of powerlessness that's pointed right at me. In other words, I messed up my life in a very powerful way and I can't do anything about it. So it's that combination of powerlessness and self-depreciation that is very crippling. It's a hard place to start. The next thing that we would encourage you to do is recognize that some days you feel much better than others. And the next thing that we would like you to remember is that things are always working out for you. And so what we think that what's troubling you about this, and we know this will resonate with you as you hear this, when you were resolved that you were going, you felt strong and clear-minded. That's what resolved is. And there was more alignment in that. When he did something then that made it appear that now you couldn't reverse your decision, like you were locked in, you felt more powerless. Mm-hmm. Then you begin regaining your balance, you begin feeling better, and in doing so, you draw him back into your experience. And as he calls your mother, or he shows up in his car near you. And when that happens, it causes your decision to fluctuate again. So it's that lack of decision. And what we can feel you saying is, what if I made the wrong decision, or how do I keep from continuing the wrong decision? We can feel you haven't made a decision whether you want that to be the relationship that you are trying to bring around, or whether you're wanting another relationship. And if we were standing in your physical shoes, we would be reaching for a fresh new relationship. Now, that doesn't mean that it can't end up being a fresh new relationship with a person that was not so fresh and new at one time. But if you would get focused, in other words, remember what was it that made you move out? Tell us. In other words, what culminated that made that rocket of desire happen?
It had gotten to a very unhealthy place. He was drinking a lot, doing pot a lot. Things were out of control with his daughter. In fact, he has fallen away. He's estranged from his core group of friends over similar issues. I had a 3.5-week migraine, and friends just actually did an intervention just to pull me out of that environment.
So, thinking back, did it feel better then or now? You have to think about that.
Well, I mean, glad to be out of that. It was at that point.
So
it wasn't
We understand, but things have improved dramatically for you. So does that mean you made a wrong decision or a right decision? In other words,
it was the right decision.
You were stepping in the right direction.
Yes.
And so if we were standing in your physical shoes, we would keep stepping in that direction. Because the worst thing that can happen is that you can get so tuned in, tapped in, turned on, that you evoke from him alignment so that the two of you go off in harmony together. The worst thing that could happen is that you get in alignment with who you are and in alignment with your images of what a relationship should be like, which you've launched many, 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 many rockets of desire about, and Source would deliver to you another person with whom to have that relationship. In other words, in any event, you cannot lose. You just don't have to figure out who, where, when, how. And so you've lived the life that did the work, and you followed your impulse. Now don't second guess it. And just let your work say things to yourself such as, I've come this far, and it's easier for me to get into a better feeling place now than it has been before. And I'm just going to keep working on this. If this process doesn't work, I'll try this one. And if this one doesn't work, I'll try this one until I get into a better feeling place consistently. And then the universe will yield to me something that I really, really like.